Hello everyone, I am Mr. Sachin Rathod, working as assistant professor in mechanical engineering department from Walchand of Technology Solapur. Today we are dealing with epicyclic gear train. The learning outcome is at the end of this session, student will be able to calculate the speed ratio of epicyclic gear train supporting frame on which the gear A is mounted with an axis O1. This one is the arm which connects the gear B about the center O2. So in this mechanism, if suppose the arm, we have make the arm fixed, and if you have driven the gear A, so that the gear B will get rotated. So it is a kind of the simple gear train. If suppose we have fixed the gear A, so the arm will forcefully will get rotates around the gear A, and B also try to rotate upon the gear A. So the gear B is rotated upon and around the gear A, that's why it is called as a epicyclic one. So in this diagram, if suppose we have to assume that, we have to assume that the arm is fixed, and gear A rotates through one revolution. Gear A rotates through plus one revolution. You have to consider the anti-clockwise direction as a plus, so I can write that anti-clockwise direction. So this is my first condition, arm is fixed, the gear A makes the plus one rotation in anti-clockwise direction. So under this consideration, if suppose in this diagram, as the arm is fixed, if the gear A makes the one rotation, we can easily find out the rotation of the gear B by using the simple gear train. So we are knowing the relation between speed of the A divided by the speed of the B. It is inversely proportional to the number of the teeth. That is, we are getting TB by TA. Therefore, the speed of B is equal to TA by TB into NA. As the A makes the one rotation, it is a one. Therefore, we are getting NB is equal to TA by TB. So, as the arm is fixed, the gear A makes the one rotation, we are getting the speed of the B as TA by TB. But if you observe that the gear A and gear B are meshes externally, so if the gear A rotates in the anti-clockwise direction, so that the gear B will rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. So, we are getting the negative term. Okay. Then the next condition is that arm is fixed and gear A makes, instead of the plus 1, here we are assume that it rotates through the plus 1, but consider that the gear A makes the x revolution in anti-clockwise direction. So we can easily find out, as the gear A, instead of the 1, it makes the x rotation. Therefore, we are getting NB is equal to TA by TB into NA. So here we are considering the A is equal to X. Therefore, NB is equal to X into TA by TB. And as the A rotates in the anti-clockwise, B rotates in the clockwise. So we are getting the negative sign. So these are the two main basic condition of motion. So simply we will check this table. Directly on that table we are getting. So arm is fixed, the gear A rotates through the one rotation, that is one revolution in anti-clockwise direction. So first one is your the arm. Okay. After that arm, the gear A is there. This is a gear A, and gear A mesh with the gear B. So the arm is fixed, so the revolution of the element arm is zero. A makes the plus one rotation. So we are getting the motion of the B is minus TA by TB. Next condition, arm is fixed, so the speed of the arm is zero, and instead of the one rotation, it makes the x rotation. So just for the x rotation, we are getting minus x into TA by TB. Then the next step is that add y rotation to all element. So this is a y rotation. If you add, if suppose that this is arm, we are rotating by the y rotation. So each and every element is rotated by the y revolution. So we have to add plus y revolution to each element. So we have to make the total revolution. So here we have to make the addition of 2 and 3. We have to not consider the first condition because it is for the one rotation. We are not knowing how much revolution of the gear A is there. That's why don't consider this. So we are finding for the x revolution and also we are considering the motion of the arm. That's why make the addition of condition number 2 and 3. So here we are getting the y, x plus y, y minus x into TA by TB. This is a table of the motion. So by considering this, if any one terms we are knowing, we can easily find out the speed of the other element. So the question is that what is the application of epicyclic gear train? So generally in case of the differential gearbox, we are using the epicyclics, means in that gear, so like this arrangement is there. So this is the arm. So such kind of the gear is called as a epicyclic gear train, means around this gear the other gears are rotated, that is called as a epicyclic gear train. Otherwise in the back gear of the lathe machine, the epicyclic gear train is there, or in case of the merchant navy machines, we are using the epicyclic gear train. So lot of the applications are there of the epicyclic gear train. So the next one is that we have to solve this example. So in this example, and in an epicyclic gear train carries the two gears A and B having 36 and 45 teeth respectively. So the given data are, so I will write down the given data. TA is equal to 36, TB is equal to 45. If the arm rotates 150 rotation in the anticlockwise, means speed of the arm is equal to 150 in anticlockwise. That's why we have taken a plus sign. For the anticlockwise rotation, we have to consider the plus sign, and for the clockwise rotation, we have to consider the negative sign. Centers about the gear A. The gear A, which is fixed, I mean speed of the gear A is fixed. Speed of gear A is fixed, means the speed rotation is zero. Determine the speed of B. We have to calculate the speed of B. This is a question. So under this question, the arm is fixed, the gear A makes the one rotation, that is the one rotation in clockwise. So these are the condition which is fixed, just we have to formulate this table depending upon the motion. So here the arm is fixed, so this first one is the arm, second one gear A, gear A mesh with the gear B. So if suppose arm is fixed, the rotation is zero, gear A makes the plus one rotation, so we have to find out the speed of the B. We can easily find out the speed of the B, that is the NA by NB is equal to TB by TA. That's why we are getting the speed of the B is equal to TA by TB. And though both gear are meshes externally, so we have to change the sign convention. So this, in this way, we have to calculate the speed of the B. So next one, the arm is fixed, the gear A rotates through the plus X revolution. Just we have to multiply with the X. So here the arm is fixed, X into TA by TB. Next one, add the Y revolution to all element, plus y plus y plus y. So here we have to calculate the total motion, y x plus y y minus x into TA by TB. So this is a total motion. So we have to check out the condition. So here they had given a speed of the arm is equal to 150. So speed of the arm is nothing but your y. Therefore for the first condition, y is equal to 150 rpm. And if suppose gear A is fixed, if the gear A means x plus y is equal to fixed means 0, therefore x plus y is equal to 0. If you put the equation number 1 in this case, therefore we are getting y is equal to minus x, therefore x is equal to minus 150 rpm. Okay, so we are getting the value of the x is equal to minus 150 rpm. Right now we are knowing the value of y and x. We have to calculate the speed of the B. Therefore speed of the B, total speed of the B is y. Therefore speed of the B is equal to y minus x into TA by TB. If you put the value, y is equal to 150. 150 minus x is equal to minus 150. So it will get plus 150 into TA by TB. 36 divided by 45. So we can easily calculate this equation. B is equal to 270 rpm in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so the next question, again they had given us, if the gear A, instead of being fixed rates, makes the 300 rpm in clockwise direction, what is the speed of the B? So instead of this zero, they had given us speed of the A is equal to 300 rpm in clockwise. So that's why we have to consider the clockwise, means here the minus 300. What is the speed of B, and V is equal to how much? So just give, they are given speed of the A. So here Y, we are knowing speed of the A, X plus Y, instead of the zero, it will make X plus Y is equal to minus 300. Just put the Y is equal to 150, therefore X is equal to minus 300 minus Y is equal to minus 300 minus 150 is equal to minus 450. So we are getting the value of the X is equal to minus 450. We have to find out the speed of the B. Speed of the B, and B is equal to Y minus X into TA by TB. Therefore Y is equal to 150 minus X is minus 450, therefore plus 450 into TA by TB. TA is 36 by 45. So the speed of the B is equal to 510 rpm. So it is a plus sign we are getting in the anti-clockwise direction. So here the first answer is that 270 rpm in anti-clockwise direction, and for the second condition we are getting speed of the B is 510 rpm in. So these are my references.